So we'll talk a little bit about, and I'm a president of a company, we're actually trying to do some more things with DBS. I may mention that at the end, but it doesn't relate to this talk. So I'll talk a little bit about deep brain stimulation, sort of how we got here, how we think it works, because I think that's still an unknown. Where do we stand with not just the indications for Parkinson's or essential tremor, but what about the other things that we're working on? What about the issue of microelectrode guidance, which is what MER stands for, versus image guidance, which is what we're doing right now? And then what might be the horizon for DBS? And I think it's pretty exciting. Like a lot of things in medicine, this was sort of discovered by accident. So some colleagues of mine, 1982, noticed something that actually I was taught as a resident. I was a University of Washington resident in the late 70s, early 80s. And I was taught that when you're doing procedures like the ablative surgeries, thalamotomy was the only one that we actually did at that time, if you stimulated before you did the lesion, you could influence the tremor. That was just common knowledge. But it wasn't until these folks in 1982 were implanting electrodes for pain, because there was a whole decade where DBS was used for pain, and that was the only indication. They noticed this patient had tremor, and when they stimulated, tremor went away, which was pretty cool. So, but they never did anything about it. This, my colleague, Alan Benabid, Ben, was a real, he's a super nice person, very smart guy, spent a year studying the thalamus in San Diego, and kind of heard about this and said, we should be able to stimulate and control tremor. So he started in the mid-80s looking at tremor, and by the end of that decade, it was pretty clear that we could reduce tremor by deep brain stimulation at a target in the thalamus. So, and about that time, that's when I visited with him. I heard about it, took a trip to Grenoble, saw what he did, learned about his methods. I had already done a lot of the work because I was working in the pain area before that for DBS, and also using microelectrodes, other things that were most neurosurgeons didn't know how to do. So I took it immediately back to Oregon. We went through all the process to get the FDA approvals for that. And I'm going to show you that one more time because that video there is important. And so we went through all the FDA process, did the initial studies on that. Eventually, I sat on the Medicare panels to get the thing approved by the way, it was a funny story, Parkinson's disease. And right at the end of the meeting, when the CMS was about to vote on, yes, we'll approve it, I said, essential tremor too. Can you put that in there? And they go, okay. And that was how essential tremor got approved. So, and today it's approved for those two indications and with a little variation, dystonia. So dystonia is a different, slightly different problem. So so then we did all this work, and the very first implant was this gentleman here, a former airline pilot, believe it or not. Remember Northwest Airlines? He had had a thalamotomy. If you look at the right side, his right arm is pretty good. So that's an ablation procedure, thalamotomy. But I've never wanted to do that on both sides. First guy implanted, turns it on, totally stopped the tremor. I have to tell you, my colleagues, and it's hard to impress a neurosurgeon, they were just dumbfounded by this. They'd never seen anything like it before. So this was 91, and we did the first implant, and then we did the first randomized controlled trial, so trying to figure out how this worked. Now that's for Parkinson's disease, and then it went on to be one of the lead centers for this, probably the biggest surgical trial for Parkinson's that will ever be done, which is this NIH VA trial when did we finish that? Late 2007, 2008?
Yeah.
And papers are still coming out from that.
Continuing to follow people 15.
But basically what our study showed in 99 and then later is comparing implantation, DBS implantation to best medical therapy, hands down, DBS was better. Pretty much across the board.